Hello, welcome to Sculpt with Sid. My name is Sydney. I'm a barre, Pilates, and yoga instructor from Toronto. And today we're going to do a glutes and core focus class. We're going to do Pilates style exercises and use a booty band. So if you've got one, grab one. If not, no worries. Either way, we'll get started seated. Let's go. Begin with an inhale to sit up tall. Exhale, drop your shoulders down your back. One more like that. Inhale for length. Exhale, soften. Good, start to just roll your head in a few circles, releasing any tension from your neck. Continuing to connect your breath to your movement. Good, even out. Come back up through center. On an inhale, reach both arms to the ceiling. Exhale, left hand to right knee, right hand behind you. Find a gentle twist, waking up your spine. Inhale, back through center, reach up. Exhale, twist, find your opposite knee, rotate. Good, feel nice. Inhale, back through center, side bend to the right. Stretch left side body. Inhale, back through center, switch sides. Good, inhale, back through center one more time. Just plant your hands down on your mat, find a tabletop. So come onto hands and knees. We'll just do one cat-cow. So on an inhale, drop your belly, lift your gaze. Stretch out the front side body. Exhale, round your spine, tuck your chin. Stretch out the back. Good. Find a neutral spine right in between those two shapes. I want you to imagine someone's about to punch you in the stomach. You would brace for impact. So think belly button to spine, ribs towards hips. You're really tightening up through your core. Keep that connection. And then find a little squeeze in your seat, like you're trying to squeeze your butt cheeks together. Keep all this engagement. And then just lift your right leg back. You can keep it nice and bent. And then bring it back down. Switch sides. You're lifting on an exhale. Lowering on an inhale. I want you to try to do this slow. This is our warm up, but we're kind of easing into movement today. I want your focus to be on your breath for this class and see if you can use your breath to connect a little bit more to the work that's happening. So right here, as you exhale, you're bracing through your core like someone's about to punch you, and you're squeezing your heel to seat to really light up through your glutes. Sometimes it takes a while for our muscles to activate to wake up. And that's why connecting with your breath and moving slow is a really great way to just kind of speed up that process, even though we're not moving quick. We're gonna do one more each side. Good, even out. And then find a full plank. If your wrists are starting to bug you, come down onto your elbows. Either way, lengthen your legs back and hold. Good, now all your focus is on your core. Pull up through your belly button. Find that squeeze of your rib cage down and in. Beautiful, once you're here, now can you think about squeezing your seat? Maybe step your big toes to touch, squeeze your inner thighs as well. Notice how engaging the lower body helps in your plank, makes your hips not feel so heavy, and find a little bit more strength. We're here for four. Good, three. Two, take an inhale. Exhale, find a down dog. Good work, cuddle out your knees. You can bend one and the other. Take a deep breath. And our quick warm-up is done. Check in, see how you're feeling. And we'll get into some work right away. On your next breath, just come down onto your shins. Sit onto your right side. We're gonna put the band on and then lie all the way down onto your right side. So again, if you don't have a band, no worries, just lie on down. If you are putting it on, I like it above my knees. You could also have it on your ankles for this one. We're literally gonna lie all the way down. You get to rest your head on your arm and then send your toes out on a tiny diagonal line out in front of you. It'll be a little bit easier to balance. Once you're here, right ribs are gonna lift away from the floor. So you're squeezing that side obliques, belly button to spine. This is as much core as it's gonna be side booty. All right, so all we're gonna do is lift your left leg. Take an exhale, lift the leg up into the band and then come back down. Don't let the legs touch. Good, as you exhale, find that lift, push up against the band. Inhale, release, but keep squeezing the inner thighs to resist on the way down. Good. Keep going like this, and I'm gonna give you a few options if this doesn't feel too good. So you can do your classic clams, knees bend in front of you, open and close by rotating the legs from the hip joint. If that feels better, go there. And if it feels really awkward to be all the way down, you can always come up onto your forearm, do the same thing with your legs. Or some people in my classes like to do the standing. You could fully stand on up and do the same thing. You'll work your balance a little bit more. So if you're in the mood to stand up, you can come here. Just keep moving with your breath. Squeezing in through the sides of your core. Pretty quickly, you'll feel that nice little ball of fire build on the side of your bum. That's what we want here. Good, we only have two more. Lift about halfway, so not your full range. Lift halfway, hold, and draw some circles like you're drawing, like you're tracing around a coffee cup with your big toe. Yeah. As you do that, the hips are gonna wanna dance a lot. Can you keep them nice and still? Four, three, two, switch directions, go the other way. Good, notice if your leg is starting to dip, try to keep it about that mid range. You got it, four, three, two, one, awesome, let that leg fall, take a breath. Good, we're gonna move both legs now. You can kind of ignore the band, you don't really need it for this next bit, but just keep it there. Left hand's gonna plant out in front of you for a little extra balance support, and then make sure your toes are on this angle in front of you. We're gonna lift both legs. So inhale to prepare, exhale, lift both legs up. Inhale, lower. Good. So the side of that left bum is still gonna work, but I want you to focus on left obliques here, doing so much work to lift the weight of both of your legs. Good, and just like we did in that plank, can you zip the inner thighs together, find that squeeze towards your midline. Okay, a few options here. Naturally, I wanna lift my head up. Helps me kind of crunch on my left side obliques. It helps to do that if you wanna tense your right fingertips, lift that elbow up, give yourself a bit of leverage, lift upper body, do a full side crunch here. And if you feel balanced, your last layer is to lift your left arm up, and then it can kind of flow with the legs, meeting them, and then reaching overhead. Either way, move with your breath. Be nice to this right bottom hip. If it's really digging into your mat, you can fold a blanket or a towel, put it under your hip. We just have three. So good, two. Last one, no holds, just lift. And come all the way down. Beautiful, bend your leg. Prop yourself up so you're on your right forearm. We're gonna come into a supported side plank. So just lift your hips whenever you get there. Left arm can come to the ceiling. Pause for a moment. Bring all your energy into your right obliques. Lift ribs up and in. Take an inhale, look up. Exhale, rotate. String your left hand underneath right side body and then open back up to the ceiling. Move with your breath. Big exhale, rotate. Inhale, lift. Good. We're not here for too long. Try to kind of lengthen and release left side body. We've switched the work to be on right side. Good, last four. Three, maybe for these last few, you wanna come to a full plank. You can extend your legs. You got two. Last one, we're gonna hold at the top. Find your side plank. If your legs are bent, I want you to do some fire hydrants. Just lift and lower that leg bent. If you're in your full plank, you can do those straight side leg lifts like we were doing when we started this side sequence. This is our way to finish it. So do whatever you can to keep your energy on this side. Breath always helps. You have four. Can you lift your hips a little higher? Get out of your right shoulder. Three. Good, two. We're gonna hold on one, pause here. Take up lots of space like you're making a big star shape with your body. One big breath in. Exhale, turn to face your mat. Find a quick child's pose. Send your bum back. Amazing work, shake out your head. Roll yourself on up and then just swing your legs around. We gotta do side two. But the best part is that you get to start fully lying down. So get nice and comfy, lie flat, let your head rest on your left arm. And then remember, you can point your toes out in front of you on a bit of an angle. Once you're set up here, brace through your core, left ribs lift away from your mat, and then find that full leg extension. Right leg lifts on an exhale, lowers down halfway on an inhale. Ooh, good, enjoy this little lying down moment. Things will only get spicier from here on out in this class. Remember all your options that I gave you on side one. You can pick or choose a different one on side two, depending on how your hip feels. Again, you could do your clams, or you could come all the way up. I know that you can change what your upper body is up to and do the same thing with your legs. Good, slowly feel Feeling the work build fully on this right side body. So as you lift, glute med firing up, but also your obliques to lift the weight of the leg against the band. We're not here for too much longer. Try to keep your energy up by breathing really big. We have two more. You've got it. Last full one, lift and lower. Woo! And then lift halfway. Find those circles. Again, your big toes tracing your coffee cup. It's super small, it's super controlled. Pay attention to your top hip, keep it still. Woo, last four, three, two, switch directions. Don't drop your leg, you just have eight. You can do it, send energy to your toes. Four, three, two, one. Ah, so good. All right, keep your legs together, give them a big squeeze. And this time you can roll fully onto your left butt cheek. So inhale to prepare, exhale, lift both legs. Squeeze right side obliques, and then gently lower both legs back down. Good, so you kind of have that little bit of a rotation back so that you're not fully on the side of your left hip, because that's usually a little bony, a little uncomfortable. So find the squishy part of your bum. Yeah, and then once you've got the hang of this, really, really focus on right obliques. Sing in as you exhale to lift your legs. Good, and then choose if you want to tense your fingertips. Find that full side crunch, lift upper body. Come back down with control. I know this feels ridiculous. It looks ridiculous, but do what you can to move with control. Try not to come up and then go like this. It just like doesn't feel very good. You might injure yourself. I want you to control in both directions. Yes. And when you do notice your form start to kind of give, or your body's starting to do weird things because you're tired, that's a good sign to take a break. I won't cue a ton of breaks in my classes here, but it's really up to you to listen to your body, take them intentionally, but not for too long. Just take a nice little quick break. Once you're feeling better, come back with that proper form, that extra bit of energy. You can always pause the video too if you need like a proper break. Ah, two more. Last one, make it count. Ah, come all the way down, so good. All right, come up onto your forearm and your knees. Find that supported side plank or full side plank, whatever you wanna do on this left side. Right arm reaches up, inhale, look up. Exhale, rotate. Keep going like that, nice and slow and controlled. Feel free to change up your side plank. If rotations are not your jam, just reach to the ceiling and then tap that hand down. You have four more here. Every time you open back up, can you lift your hips a teensy bit higher? Can you pull your left ear away from left shoulder? You're doing so good. You only have one more. Exhale, twist. Inhale, open. Pause, lift that right leg up and down. Bent or straight, whatever feels best to finish here. And try to keep your hips high. Yes, tell yourself you've got this. You know this is the end of your side sequence. We're gonna stand up soon. You have four. Three. Two. We're gonna hold on one. You knew that was coming. Lift on up, hold. Just take one big breath. So good, come on down. Find that quick child's pose, bum comes back. Take a breath. Begin to roll yourself up so hands come close to knees. You can tuck your toes, come through a forward fold. Pause when you get there. Here, you can step out of the band and keep it in your hands. We're gonna stand up with it. So once it's in your hands, roll up to stand. Head comes up last. Give yourself a little shake if you need some release. We're gonna hold the band in your hands. Come to the top of your mat so that you've got some room to step behind you. Arms are gonna come overhead, pause. Notice right away if your rib cage flares. Tuck it in, squeeze, find that containment again like you're about to be punched. You're gonna row the right elbow down, lift the right knee up, squeeze through your core, and then switch sides. You guessed it, we're gonna move slow so that you can connect to your breath. Exhale as everything bends, inhale as you lengthen. Good, if this really connects with you and you're like, ooh, I wanna really work on this, work on my balance, work on my core strength standing, I want you to stay right here. If you would like to add on a little bit of lower body work to this, find your march on the right side. do that row. And then as you straighten your arms, you're gonna step your right foot back, arms overhead, come into a lunge. Same thing, march, and then switch sides. So right side comes down, left side marches, pause, find your balance. Step back, lunge, both arms overhead. Find that march and row again, and then switch. All right, so keep going side to side like that. The focus here is still pretty much on your core. If you want a little bit more glutes, add a few pulses at the bottom of your lunge. You know your body way, way, way better than I do. So listen to it. Some days, we don't know how we're gonna feel when we come into our mat to work out, and then you just have that like magic burst of energy. Use that, enjoy that, add on those days. And we all have those days, especially in winter, when you were hoping for the best, but the energy is just not coming to you. If you're having one of those days, ditch the lunge, ditch the pulses. You could also ditch the band. As long as you're moving with your breath in a way that feels good in your body, you're killing it in my book. We're gonna do one more each side. Really good work. Last time on the left, march with the left, send it back. Three pulses in your lunge. Find that march one more time. Come into a little chair. You can relax your arms for a second, give them a shake. Reach your bum back. You're gonna reach the band out in front of you and then start to row right elbow back. Punch it forward, switch sides. Good, so you'll feel a little bit more work in the backside body here, but literally everything that supports your spine is included in core work. So working on a backside body here really helps with posture and helps build that foundation for a strong core. We are not just talking about six-pack abs. We're talking about a more functional 360-degree core strength around your spine. If you want here, when the right elbow bends, you're gonna send your right foot back, come back forward, switch sides. Ooh. If that feels awkward, you can do opposite leg to arm. Again, yeah, do whatever feels best. But even though we're working backside body, again, notice if your rib cage wants to flare. I feel like I say that cue a lot because it's something that naturally happens for me. So I'm really actively working on trying to keep my ribs contained. All right, you got 4, 3, 2, and 1. Pause back in your chair. You're gonna step back into your band. And then find a sumo squat. Step your feet the width of your yoga mat, send your seat back, hold right here. All right, so take a moment, really think about bum sitting back like you're in a chair, push your thighs open into the band, think a teensy bit lower, then reconnect your core, everything we just did around your spine, keep it, take a big breath in. On your breath out, just stand tall. Oh. We're gonna move nice and slow for a second. Just getting used to your sumo stance. You could definitely widen, shorten. You can turn this out more, keep it parallel, whatever feels best with the band. Do more like this. Really good work. Come to the bottom, hold. At the bottom, you're gonna step out with the right, out with the left, back in with the right, back in with the left, and then stand, switch direction. So come low, go left, right, left. Right, stand up. So just keep alternating which foot starts first. And then if you're in the mood to move a little quicker today, and we just really haven't done that yet, you can pick up the pace a bit here. If you're someone that likes a little bit more high impact, instead of these little walks out, you can jump. So come low, jump out, jump in, stand tall. Do whatever feels best in your body. I know I always say that, but honestly, it's a good habit to build. Because sometimes we go into autopilot mode in a workout, especially when it's moves we're really familiar with. That's often when we get injured. So we're just not really listening to those cues your body's giving you about where you need to go today. Almost there. Hopefully you're feeling that burn. Come back into the lower body. You have 3, 2, Last one, and then we're gonna lift and lower to hold. So last lift, find a place to hold at the bottom. Little pulses up and down. Okay, this is your only like booty burnout standing. So I challenge you to stay with me the whole time. It's gonna be tempting to stand up. I want you to stay low as long as you can with good breath. If your shoulders start to feel a little crunchy, hands behind back is a nice place to be. Wiggle your toes, push more into your heels. You have eight like this, then we're gonna pulse eight times out and then hold. So we're almost there. You have four, three, two, hold on one, more weight in the heels. Little pulses out. If that feels awkward on your heels, you could also come onto your toes. Whatever feels better for your ankle joint, just keep pushing out. If you don't have the band, you can keep pulsing up and down. Oh, maybe your seat comes lower. Challenge yourself to find that place where that burn is building so much that you really, really want to stand up. You can take a few more deep breaths to stay. We're not here forever, though it might feel like that. You have 10 like this. Stay with me. You got 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, stand tall. So good. Step out of that band and then come back to the back of your mat. We'll do another forward fold. Come to the back, take a big inhale, reach up. Exhale, forward fold. Shake it out when you get there. Take one deep breath here. Bend the knees a lot. Drop the weight of your head. And then on your next breath, just bend the knees until you're sitting down. We're gonna come all the way to your backs. Make sure your band's nearby, but you don't need it just yet. And lie all the way down. If you need any types of release, windshield wipe, give your legs a hug, whatever you need. And then when you're ready, hands behind your back will come into some really simple ab curls. So take an inhale to do nothing. Exhale, find your ab curl, peel head, neck, and shoulders up. And then come on down nice and slow. Exhale, lift. Inhale, lower. Keep going like that. I know crunches aren't everyone's favorite, so if you want to start with marches, walk your feet further away, keep your head down, and just march one knee at a time, nice and slow, instead of ab curling. If you're comfortable holding your neck up and you want the feeling of a crunch, come up onto your elbows instead. Good, do whatever works. If you are ab curling with me, keep going. Exhale to lift, inhale to lower. We'll start to add on that march. Exhale, right knee lifts, march. Inhale, everything comes down. Exhale, left side. Inhale, everything comes down. Keep going. One more each side, and then we'll add a rotation. All right, this time you can cross left elbow towards right knee. Come back down, switch sides. If you know you love your classic bicycle crunches, you can definitely come there instead. I just challenge you to stay slow. If you have had your head down this whole time, maybe you start with knees at tabletop for the next little bit and do toe taps instead. You can definitely also add on some upper body. Do what you need to do here to find that nice big fire build in your belly without bringing any negative tension to your hip flexors or your neck. Easier said than done, so please take those intentional breaks. You got 4, 3, 2, and 1. So good. All right, drop your head, grab your band. If you have your knees a little windshield wipe, whatever you need for release. Band is gonna come on the arms, so just bring it anywhere on your forearms between, you know, your wrists, your elbows, wherever feels good. Fingertips are gonna reach towards the ceiling, feet plant. We're gonna come up into a glute bridge, so just dig into your heels, peel your hips up, pause at the top here. Good, once you're here, push into your heels so much, drag your heels towards your seat so your hamstrings catch. Yep, ribs contain in, like again, someone's gonna punch you, theme of today's class. You're about to be punched. And then just spread your arms out, little pressure of your forearms on the band. Your shoulders will light up, your upper abs will light up. All right, we're gonna do alternating heel lifts. So lift your right heel up. As you do that, bend the elbows. You're gonna row the arms. Band touches your belly button. Return to where you started and switch sides. Left heel lifts, arms row. Keep going like this. Getting used to transferring your weight side to side a little bit. If you know you love marches, then you can do that right away, lifting one full leg up, keeping the knee bent, placing it back down, switching sides. I like to have my feet pretty narrow if I'm doing full marches so that the one foot is kind of in the middle of the mat. If it's really wide, it just doesn't work. So you can make your stance really narrow. We're gonna do three more like this. And then lift your right leg and hold either in your heel lift or your march. Good, so lift your right side, hold. Hands can come back towards the ceiling. You're gonna toe tap here. So as your right toes tap away, arms come overhead and then come back in. Ooh, so we're working the glutes and the core, the actual theme of today's class. But feel free to drop your hips down. Ditch the glutes part of this. You will still feel so much great core work. And only move your arms as much as it feels good for your shoulder mobility. If I go too far, like if I come all the way back here, my shoulder kind of pops. It's never a good thing. You got three like this. If your hips are in your bridge still, can you lift them a little higher? Drive into your left heel. Two. Last one, you know we're gonna hold. Come all the way up. Pause. You can either stay still or find eight pulses. Drive into your left heel, little tiny, tiny lift. Whoo, for four, three, two. Don't drop your hips, just plant the right foot down. Lift the left knee. Good, find your toe taps. Find that reach overhead. If you connected more to the row, if that feels better for your shoulders, you can row as you toe tap. Just see how it feels on this side. Maybe your hips need to come down, that's totally fine. Maybe you wanna do a little lower as everything taps, and then a little hip lift as everything comes up. Whoo. Yeah, that's a good one. Just be really mindful here of any lower back tension, especially when we're on one leg. The low back sometimes wants to kind of hold all of your weight. So make sure that the right glute's working so hard, and your lower abs are staying really active. Support this weight of your hips. Taking breaks whenever you need. I had to just put my hips down, but I'm gonna come right back up in one more rep. So maybe you're taking a break with me and then we're going right back up right here. You've got it, we only have four left. Then we have one core hold and then today's workout is done. All right, the next time you lift, we're finding that hold, optional eight pulses. Listen to your body, do what feels like a little last push. A little last push, a big last push. Last four, three, two, one. Come all the way down. Okay, take a moment. You're gonna transfer your band to your legs. Bring it around your ankles. And then we're finding a final hold, right? So bring your legs to tabletop to start. Arms to the ceiling. Push a little bit out into the band in your legs. Just the same way you did with your forearms. Take an inhale here. On an exhale, start to reach everything away from center. Pause where you feel like you can stay contained in your core and your low back isn't like really leaving the mat. Keep pushing out in the legs. Good, if you wanna hold an ab curl, lift head, neck, and shoulders. Keep your arms overhead. Maybe legs come to a full straight. Wherever you are, we're just gonna hold. We're gonna breathe. I know that this is your last little push of class. Keep saying little, big push. Breathe. This is a big moment. Push out onto the band. Feel your lower abs starting to shake. Push your rib cage down, shoulders down. Breathing here for five, four, three, two, and one. Hug your knees in. Amazing work. Take that band off your legs. We'll do a quick release. Please don't leave me now. The end of class is the best part, I promise. Come all the way onto your back, give your legs a hug, and then we'll find a quick figure four. Cross your right ankle over left thigh. You can thread the needle. Find a gentle rock side to side, really stretching out the side of your hip. After all that banded glute work. Switch sides, cross left ankle, and thread the needle or keep your hips planted. Good, unwind your legs, rock and roll up and down your spine and just flip on over. We'll find a few cat cows, just like how we started class. On an inhale, drop your belly, look up. Exhale, round your spine, look down. You can do a few more like that. The ones we did at the beginning of class might have felt a little creaky, a little small. Hopefully you have a little more space and heat in your body to enjoy the spinal release. Good, come to a neutral spine. Sit your hips back onto your heels. Give your head a few of those rolls. If you want to take a few of those twists, go for it. Whatever last little wiggles of movement you need to release. Good, and then find stillness. Take one last breath together. Inhale, reach your arms up. Palms touch. Exhale, pull them down through heart center. Give yourself a little round of applause. Keep saying little, a big round of applause for all your hard work today. And as always, I want to genuinely thank you for choosing to work out with me. Please let me know in the comments if you did class, what you thought of it, how you're feeling, and any requests for next time. Have a great rest of your day.